There are new software assurance core benefits that are going to make running SQL Server on an Azure virtual machine even cheaper than it was before. Learn more in this episode of Data Exposed. Hi, I'm Anna Hoffman, and welcome to this episode of Data Exposed. Today, I'm joined by Amit, a group program manager on the Azure Data team. Amit, why don't you tell us a little bit about what you do?
Thanks, Anna. Great to be here. So I'm part of the Azure Data Engineering team. I'm responsible for the SQL Server database engine running outside of Azure and on Azure Virtual Machines.
Awesome. And today I'm excited because we're going to be talking about software assurance and how that relates to SQL Server and Azure VM and how free can be a part of this. And I don't really know a lot about any of these things, so I'm excited to learning more. Why don't you go ahead and tell us about software assurance and some of these benefits that are available to our SQL customers?
Absolutely, Anna. So I'm going to switch over to a slide that I prepared for this video. We actually have a benefit called Azure Hybrid Benefit that SQL Server customers with software assurance or subscription licenses are able to leverage on Azure. One of the most recent things that we announced was the core multiplier benefit, where if you have one core, in this example, if you have one core of SQL Server Enterprise license, you can actually use it for one core on a SQL Server Enterprise virtual machine, or you can actually use it for four cores of standard edition in a VM. So what that means is if you have six SQL Server Enterprise core licenses, you can actually stand up a SQL Server virtual machine with six cores, or you could stand up four different SQL Server standard virtual machines with four cores each. So that kind of makes it a multiplication effect. So in this example, you see six translates to six cores of Enterprise Edition, and six cores translates to 24 cores of Standard Edition. And once we look at this benefit, you would understand that customers that have their enterprise and standard licenses covered with software assurance, they can fungibly use both these licenses between their standard and enterprise VMs. In addition to that, we announced a benefit last year in November where software assurance customers and subscription license customers could get one free replica for high availability and disaster recovery, which already existed. In addition to that, we started providing an additional free core for disaster recovery and an additional free core for disaster recovery if that VM was residing on Azure. And in both cases, those DR VMs needed to have asynchronous replication. And we kind of redefined the rules for passive replica as well. On passive replicas, you're not able to run operations like consistency checks, log backups, full backups, monitor the VMs for health, for resource usage, and at the same time run DR drills without incurring any additional license costs. So we've kind of simplified how passive replicas and how they work. So let's see how this actually stitches together before and after November 1st, and the most common configuration that we see on Azure Virtual Machines. In this setup, what you see is we have two availability group replicas in East US and two others in West US. So the first one is the primary, the second one in server two is actually the high availability replica, which is a sync secondary, and the remaining two are asynchronous secondary. And what you see on your screen over here is essentially before November 1st, 2019, you would have to pay for six of the cores on the third and the fourth server. But post November 1st, you only have to pay for one of them. So the first replica is the HA replica, the second one is the async DR replica, and any additional replica you actually need to pay for. So let's kind of extend that and see what happens when you actually use that for reads. So for reads, because it's not passive, you'd have to end up licensing that. But now if you have a fourth replica, which is a DR-only replica and is passive and is asynchronous in nature, then you can actually not pay for the licenses for the fourth replica. And the passive replica could use any feature. I'm showing this example with availability groups. You could actually use log shipping. You could use on basic availability groups and standard edition, which limits you to two replicas, or you could use backup restore or even database mirroring for setting up the high availability sync secondary. DES mirroring, as you see, is a deprecated feature. We don't recommend using it, but we understand that you might have older releases of SQL Server, so we kind of extended that benefit to be feature agnostic. So let's see some other common configurations that customers use. This one is another common one across regions. We see customers actually using distributed availability groups, which essentially allows you to create a forwarder in between your primary and your remaining secondary replicas. And why is that helpful? It actually helps reduce the network bandwidth requirements between the primary and the other replicas. In this case, you see Server 3 acting as the forwarder. In this case, the forwarder always needs to be licensed because it's not passive. However, after November 1st, Server 4 need not be licensed. So that's another way you can actually save on cost in another type of configuration. This is very common for customers that did not have availability groups, especially before SQL Server 2012. Failover clustering was very common for setting up high availability solutions with shared storage. So you've seen customers that are moving into Azure asking for support for failover cluster instances. Recently, we added SQL Server failover cluster instance support on Azure Virtual Machines using Azure Shared Disk. So now you have the ability to actually deploy a failover cluster solution with SQL Server running in an Azure Virtual Machine using the same practices and the same patterns that you're used to on-premises. So this kind of makes your lift and shift a lot easier. But at the same time, from a licensing perspective, nothing changes. And it's important to point out, in this case, in VM2 and VM3, they were never really running a SQL Server replica. They were just waiting for a failover to happen, which is why there's no change between before and after when we announced the software assurance benefits. The same thing applies if you have an additional instance in this architecture. Node 2 that you see here on the screen is actually running a second SQL Server failover cluster instance, which means now you have two different failover cluster instances active on two different virtual machines. And in that case, every time you have an active SQL Server instance running on the machine, which is serving production applications, you need to license them. So that's why the licensing now increases from 6 to 12, 6 for each VM, and there's no change. So these are the different common things that we find customers are very excited about when they're leveraging SQL Server in a virtual machine on Azure. We hope that you are able to leverage these benefits. Please go over to aka.ms Azure SQL VM to know more details about what features we offer. And we hope to see you in our next episode.
Thanks, Amit. I just had a few questions as we kind of round this out. One, looking over all of this, it's very interesting to see the different options that are available and also kind of like the free cores that are not new, but I'm guessing probably a lot of people didn't know about these things that came in November 2019. Which one do you think would be the best, or which one do you see most customers moving towards and taking advantage of? Is it, you know, customers moving their enterprise cores to getting more cores in standard and virtual machine, or is it some of these high availability architectures, or maybe a combination of both?
We definitely see a combination of both, but the most common one that we see customers leverage is this architecture right here. You would want to have a high availability replica in one of the regions and have an equivalent setup in another region just to ensure that you have the right capacity to fail over or even switch them on for DR drills and DR purposes. And this is what we see as the most common configuration. In certain configurations, customers just get rid of Server 4 because they're running in Azure, and it's very easy to set up a replica if they want to set up one from scratch. So if I had to, you know, talk about what's the most common one we see customers ask us about, this is the most common one.
Awesome, cool. And this is one where you can save 6 cores where previously you couldn't. Thanks so much, Amit, for being on the show. We are going to do a few more SQL Server and Azure Virtual Machine. You want to give us a sneak peek of what's next?
Sure. So in this one, we talked about what free cores and benefits software assurance customers have. What I would like to do in one of the future episodes is even talk about what virtual machine benefits are offered to any SQL Server customer in Azure. So I'm pretty excited about that video as well.
Awesome. I'm looking forward to it as well, and I think our viewers will too. If you like this video, please like our video, subscribe to our channel, and we hope to see you next time on Data Exposed.